Now we are going to connect using SSH. We enter the SSH command, the username, the @symbol, and the IP address. This one changed, so I set the password again. After modifying the registry entries, the connection accesses the Raspberry Pi shell. Once in the terminal, we list the files and change to the ARM64 folder. To solve example 16, we create a file called 16complement.s using nano to edit it. We write the global directive and the start tag twice to start it. The mov instruction loads the immediate negative value -180 into register X1, making it ready to apply subsequent operations within the program. The neg instruction takes the contents of X1 and computes its 2's complement, generating the equivalent positive value and storing it in register X0. We write the exit code, save and quit. Then we run the LSLV script with 16 complement, and it gives us the positive value 100 as the result. To solve example 17, we created a file called 17.autn.s using nano to edit it. Upon entering it, we wrote the global directive and the start tag twice. We load the immediate value 33 into register X1 to prepare a number whose least significant bit can be determined to be an even or odd number. We apply n between X1 and the value 1. This isolates only the last bit, leaving an X0 a result that indicates whether the original number has that bit set. We write the exit code, save and quit. Then we run the LSLV script with 17 odd and it gives us the value 1, indicating that it is odd. To solve example 18, we will use a register to store the bits of the sensor state to be modified. We create a file 18sensor.s with nano to edit it. We write the global directive and the label start twice. We leave the initial state in X1 10,010 in binary, which will have the bits that represent the flags. Register X2 receives the new binary data 101 from the sensors, reflecting the current conditions of the environment and then the ORR instruction. This merges both values in register X0 using a bitwise or operation, updating the state received from the sensors. Then we write the output code. We save and quit. Then we run the LSLV script with 18 sensor and it gives us the value 23, which is 10,111 in binary as the OR result. To solve example 19, we created the file 19divsr.s using nano for editing. We placed the global directive and the start tag twice to start the program. We assign the octal number 7400 to register X1. Then we use the LSR instruction to shift 4 bits to the right and leave the result in register X0. This will perform the division of through 8040 by 16, remembering that octal 74 is equal to through 8040 in decimal. We place 4 because squared it becomes 16. We write the exit code, save, and exit. Then we run the LSLV script with 19divsr and get the value 240 as the result of the multiplication. To solve example 20, we consider the division example, but now shifting to the left to multiply, we create a file 20mosl.s with nano to edit it. We write the global directive and the label start twice. Then we assign the value 32 to register X1, which will be the number we will multiply. Then we assign the immediate value 2 to the X2 register so that its power is 4, so that we can apply it with the left shift using the LSLV instruction. The V indicates that a variable will be used instead of immediately. In register X0, we will have the multiplication of 32 by 4. Then we write the output code. We save the program and exit. Then we run the LSLV script named 20mosl and obtain the value 128, which corresponds to the multiplication of 32 by 4. To solve example 21, we created the file 21clean.s using nano for editing. We place the global directive and the start tag twice to begin. We assign the least significant part of the hexadecimal number to register x1 using the MOVS instruction. Remember that immediates are 16 bits long. To assign the most significant part of the hexadecimal number in the same register, we use the MOVS instruction applying a 16-bit left shift. Next, we need to use a mask to clear the leftmost 6 hexadecimal digits. For this, we use the value FF and the instruction MOVS to obtain 2 digits. Now we clear the register using the AND instruction between registers X1 and X2. We leave the result in register X0. Then we write the exit code. We save and quit. Then we run the SLDEC script with 21 clean AND, and it gives us the value 204, which is the decimal of the hexadecimal value CC. To solve example 22, we create the file 22mol32.s with nano. We place the global directive and the label start twice. We add .data section. We create the global variable word 1 of typed word with the hexadecimal value 2 zeros and 14f. This makes the value 16 bytes long. We also create a global variable word 2 of typed word with the hexadecimal value of 6 zeros, 2f, 7 zeros, and finally the value 1. We load the address of global variable word 1 into register X1, then using that register we load its content from hexadecimal into register X2. We load the address of the global variable word 2 into register X3, then, using that register, we load its contents from hexadecimal into register X4. By mistake register X2 is placed, we correct it to register X3. Then we must multiply both contents with the mol instruction leaving the result in W0. Since a 32-bit multiplication was requested, we use the W registers. By using these registers, we limit the size to the least significant part. We write the exit code and correct any errors entered. We save the program, exit, and run the script. The result is 255, that is, the byte FF. To solve example 23, we create the file 23mod.s with nano. We place .global and the label start twice. We assign the value 10 to register x0. We assign the value 3 to register x1. Register x0 will be the x value and register x1 will be the n value. Since there is no modulo instruction, we divide first. We use sdiv and leave the result in x2, which will contain the division of x by n. Then we multiply registers x1 and x2, always leaving the result in x2. We previously divided 10 by 3, which should give 3, then the multiplication of 3 by 3 should be 9. Now we perform the subtraction using sub. We subtract x2 from x0, that is, from x which is 10, we subtract the exact division and multiplication result, which should be 9, it should give the value 1. Since the subtraction or modulo remained in register x2, we must move the result to register X0 or return register. We write the exit code, save and quit. Then we run the SLDEC script with 23mod, and it gives us the value 1, just as we calculated it step by step. 10 modulo 3 gives the result 1. That's all for this video. If you liked it, leave a like, comment, subscribe, and enable notifications. See you in the next video.